Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you are having a blessed night in the Lord. Oh, come on, somebody, give him praise. Not just in the daytime, not just at nighttime, not when you get up, not when you go to church, but give God praise all the time. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Go ahead and press share, press tag, because come on, I'm tonight I'm going to break something down for you, because I think the church have something misconstrued. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So I need to, for somebody to say, I can hear you, I can see you. Oh, come on, somebody, y'all know how it is. Come on, somebody, need to say clear. Say, I see you, apostle. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Come on, somebody, I need y'all to say clear. I hear. Before I, because when I roll, I want to keep rolling. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Say, I hear your apostle, something. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Praise God. Okay, you. Thank you. Thank you, Yvonne Robinson, and also Tamika Dixon. Praise God, praise God. Okay, I want to start my, okay, remember the title, because the title, this is going to, I'm going to go very deep, but very, at the same time, I promise you, I'm going to break that thing down for you, because I think the church have it misconstrued. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. The title of it says, the devil's comfort zone is the church. That's why God says, test the spirit by the spirit. You have to ask God for wisdom and discernment. What's happening is a lot of people are not asking God for wisdom and discernment. So therefore, just to be honest with you, just because somebody say Jesus, just because somebody say Lord, just because they in church, just because they have a title, y'all sitting up there talking about that's a child of God. Y'all talking about that's a man of God. Y'all talking about that's a woman of God. I beg to differ. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So let me go ahead and read this scripture. It is coming. I'm coming out of, you're too loud. You're too loud in there, please. I you don't have to do it that loud. Thank you. All right. 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit. Why does God say this? Hold on now. Walk with me. But try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. And I think a lot of people think that's just for prophets. No, 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 no. That's for everybody, because I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to slow it down so I can really expound on what I'm saying to you. Where was the devil first? He was in heaven, right? He, as a matter of fact, he was the music director. He was the choir director. As a matter of fact, the Bible says that he was the most beautiful angel that God had made. So you have to understand, he was right there with God. So where's his comfort zone, people? Where's his comfort zone? A lot of people don't understand. His comfort zone is not in the streets. His comfort zone is in church. Oh, come on, somebody. That's why we're having so much disarray. And that's why they have the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And that's why we have so much stuff going on in church. That's what he attacks, because he's not doing outside inside, he's doing inside outside. Oh, come on, somebody, let me bring that thing back to you. He's doing inside outside, because he gets inside of the church and he works through people to create chaos on the outside, because he has no power on the outside, only through the inside. And so he uses, okay, I'm gonna go slow. I'm so excited, because when God give me a word, just one moment. You're doing that too loud in the living room. You're doing it too loud. You ain't got to do it that loud. I'm doing a thank you. Hallelujah. Okay, so let me slow this thing down, because I'm very excited for what God, when he tells me something, I just get so excited. He said, Deanna, too many people are getting hit. He said, too many of my people do not recognize the spirit. A lot of people don't even understand what the Holy Spirit is. Y'all don't understand what I'm saying, what he's a person. But let me break this thing down. Okay, so Satan was with God. So he's a spirit, right? But actually, they call him Satan, Lucifer. Come on, somebody, he's a demon, a high demon. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So what happens? It's spirits that's transferred. You remember how God says in Jeremiah, he says, before I formed you, I knew you. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So you're spirits. So I'm going to break this thing down slow, because it's going to be deep. If you're looking for something like bam, 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 you might want to get off here right now. But if you're looking for some wisdom and discernment and some real hard, I'm talking about spiritual wisdom tonight, go ahead and text somebody and share and stay and listen. I'm going to take it slow. All right. So we're talking about host. What is a host? Don't you know that Satan has no authority on earth, yet he have a host? He has to get a host. What is a host? He has to use somebody. Wait a minute. What are the people, or who are the people that he mainly use? I hate to say it, it's Christians or someone that profess. But now notice what he does. He transforms himself into an angel of light. So when it says many false prophets, it wasn't just talking about false prophets. What they was talking about is false Christians. Oh, come on, somebody. I got to go here tonight, because I got to tell you something. God says we're getting hit too much. Y'all calling people, oh, that's a man of God, that's a woman of God, and you're causing your own self sorrows, God says, because you can identify. Just because somebody talk powerful, look powerful, have a title, come on somebody, can dress the part, I test you, come on somebody, hallelujah. As a matter of fact, please don't believe everything I say. Test the spirit by the spirit, and guess what, it's something in the inside of you that will confirm that's a man of God, that's a woman of God. Come on somebody, hallelujah. God told me to tell you, you have to start testing people more. That's why some of you are getting blindsided. That's why we have so much church hurt. That's why we have people that don't trust people. Come on, somebody. That's why outsiders don't trust the insiders. Oh, come on, somebody. And the insiders telling the outsiders your business. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Every church service, I promise you, there's two witches, two warlocks. You can write it down, take a picture. There are two warlocks. Let me tell you something. The devil's comfort zone is the church, right? Because remember where he was made and where he was. So that's what's going on in today's society. Y'all thinking it's bad outside. It's bad on the outside because it's bad on the inside. Because people are not filled with the Holy Ghost. People do not know the word of God. And I'm not trying to knock nobody, condemn nobody, judge nobody. Y'all don't know your word. That was the first thing the Lord made me do. You guys, people thought I was crazy when I got in Sacramento. After Bible college, or even during Bible college, I'm not kidding, I would sit at that table on purpose. Because here's the deal. You notice if you lay in the bed or you get somewhere comfortable, you start getting sleepy from reading the Bible, right? That ain't just Satan. That is the position that you have yourself in. So here's the deal. Get at a table, make yourself a desk, whatever you got to do, but you got to learn that word. God told me to tell every last one of you, and please spread it. You got to learn that word, because if you don't know no word, then you ain't got no power. And if you ain't got no power, you can't stop Satan. And let me tell you something. If you don't put nothing in, you ain't got nothing out. Let me tell you how laying hands work too. Oh, I feel the power of the Holy Ghost, y'all. The reason why people can really feel the power of God is because they prepared for the power of God. A lot of you don't have no word in you. So let's say somebody powerful come to the church. You say, well, I didn't feel nothing. That's because you ain't got nothing in you. Oh, come on, somebody. Don't get mad. I'm just telling you the truth. You ain't got nothing in you, because you got to have something in you in order to feel it. Let me go here. When the woman with the issue of blood for 12 years, the reason that she can feel the spirit of God, because she had the spirit. That's why when Jesus was walking, he said, who touched me? Because virtue went out of him, because it came from her. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying? When she touched him, he felt the virtue. And then virtue, it was an agreement, the power of agreement. That's why God said, if any two shall touch and agree, it shall be done. So when she touched him, it was the virtue. And he said, who touched me? Because I felt the virtue go out of me. That's how that woman got healed. It was a power of agreement. It wasn't just Jesus. I know you thought it was just Jesus. And I'm not saying Jesus is not powerful. Oh, yes, he is. But she had something inside. Oh, come on, somebody. That's why God says this kind come up but by fasting and praying. A lot of you don't want to fast, and a lot of you don't have time to pray because you're too busy after that dollar. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm just being real with you. I got a lot of information tonight. So you're going to have to go back and play this, because I'm going to be honest with you. Y'all know I've been fasting and you know, I'm on one. It's like when you fast, I'm telling you, something happens on a different level. I can't explain it to you. I'm going to do a video on that later. So what God was telling me, he said, Deanna, they don't understand. In order to truly understand my spirit, they must be in the spirit. The church ain't getting in the spirit. And how you know? There's too many arguments. There's too much bitterness. There's too much offensive. When you walk in the spirit, tell the truth. Come on, somebody. Talk to me on here. Somebody have done it. All of you have done it at least one time in your life. At least I pray you have. You're calmer. You start to think clearer. You answer very slow. James 1:19, slow to speak, quick to hear, slow to wrath. Y'all know it's true, because when you're in the spirit, what's happening? You're not being led by the flesh. You're being led by the spirit, so you can operate in the spirit. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Y'all, are y'all listening to what I'm saying tonight? Because it's really deep. I don't know why nobody calling me. They know better than that. I'm going to turn this phone off, because I'm not playing. I got to go. So anyway, long story, what God was saying, he said, Deanna, tell them that they have to get more in the spirit. That's why Satan's winning out there, because we're losing in here. When I say in here, I'm talking about a church. And hold on. The church is not just a building. The church is a relationship. That's what God told me to tell you tonight. You have to have a relationship. This is falling in love with Jesus, just like you would a man, just like you would a woman, just like you would with food, just like you would with anything, a job or anything, a car. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You got to fall in love. And when you fall in love, you get to spend time with that spirit. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You got to operate like that spirit. You start to know how the spirit operates. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. The reason why God wants you to understand what you're up against is because Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy, and it starts in the church. And if the church don't have no power, then you got to understand out there sure don't have no power. Come on, somebody, I know I turned this phone off. Y'all see what's going on, but the devil is a lie. The devil, I promise you, I turned this phone off, and I don't know how it turned back on, but the devil is a lie. Let me turn this thing off. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So what God was saying, he said, Deanna, they have to understand the seriousness and where we at. This is the last hour, people. It's not just to be said, because a lot of you are so busy worrying about what the Illuminati gonna do, what they're gonna do. Can I tell you something? That's inevitable. Whether you believe martial law is coming, and trust me, I got a video to do on that later this week. It don't matter what they do. Are you prepared? Will you be able to hear God? Because guess what? It's not going to have social media. You're not going to have your pastor. You're not going to have your preacher. You're not going to have your bishop. You're not going to have your prophet. You're not going to have your apostle. Will you be able to identify? Because I'm telling you how they're going to come. They're going to come as a sister or a brother in Christ, supposedly. I'm telling you what God is saying. That's what's happening in the church now. You cannot identify what is the Holy Spirit and what is unholy, God says. And he says the reason why is because you don't understand that the devil's comfort zone is in church. In church, he's going to always send people at you. In church, he's going to always try to devour you. In church, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. As a matter of fact, I was not kidding when I said, in every service, I don't care if you have 10 people, there's two witches and two warlocks. And I'm going to tell you, now I got some notes down. They don't come. Now, hold on. If it's no anointing, it's one witch and one warlock. They don't like them because it's not a thrill. Come on, somebody. It's not a challenge. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. How you will know? Because they love a challenge and they love very highly anointed people. As a matter of fact, the anointing attracts warlocks and witches. Why y'all think I go through so much? Trust me, I ain't in no sin and I ain't doing nothing. Come on, somebody. I ain't did all my dirt. Y'all know my testimonies. Hallelujah. The more highly anointed you are, the more Satan sin. Guess what? And hold on. He will strategically send something at you. And God will allow it. But you ever notice something about it? Every time you have a test, a trial, you get stronger in the Lord. Because guess what? It pushes you closer to God. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You start to understand. You start to spiritually mature. Because to be honest with you, that's what's wrong with the body of Christ. Most of you are babes. And how you know? Because you know how back in the day they used to say you wear your feelings on your sleeve. Nobody can't tell you nothing. Nobody can't teach you nothing. Nobody can't rebuke you. And you're easily offended. Church, we have to understand something. God is getting ready to come, but here's the deal. The church is not ready because you identify more with the world than identifying with Christ. It is time to identify with your Father, which are in heaven. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I know we have bills to pay. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I know you got kids. I know you got college tuition and all that stuff. But can I tell you something? Truth be told, God is preparing you for something greater. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And a lot of you, I got to go ahead and say this, thus said the Lord. A lot of you, God have told you to come off your job. And trust me, when he did that to me, when did God do this? Oh, my God, 2012. I'll never forget. I was working at Comcast, and I was making a lot of money. I was getting like $2,000 bonuses. I don't know how I was doing them. Well, I was one of the highest quota makers, and, you know, I was just good at my job. You know, we're talking about supervisors. I could have been, you know, seriously. I was like with them. You understand? So, and I never forget, God told me, he said, let go. I was married at the time, and I had a nice home. We had just got it. Very nice home. And you know, I used to invite people over. You know, when you really think you got it going on, you invite people. And I was so proud because they was proud. We had like a little mini movie theater, and I mean, it was just crazy. And I never forget, I'm holding on, and at that time I had cancer, so I'm working sick like a dog. I'm just being real with you. And I'm trying to hold on, because I knew my husband at that time, he had just lost his job, so I knew if I let go, we was gonna lose everything. And I never forget, God said, Deanna, let go. I said, God, we're going to lose everything. He said, yes, you are. And I cried. I said, God, I don't want to lose everything. God put me in so much positions to where my body could not take it. Plus, I was doing double shifts until I had to let go. And I never forget. I said, God, I'm going to lose everything. He said, yeah, but I'm going to show you something. I'm not lying to you. In 2012 is when I went to another level in God. Hallelujah to his name. I lost everything, you guys. I lost friends. And you know, when you lose everything, you know, she must have did something. I ain't did nothing but say yes to God, say yes to his will. Because let me tell you a secret, and this is the 23 years of ministry. When God truly called you, it'll look like it'll be a decrease. Excuse me. It'll look like it'll be a decrease because he's increasing from the inside. You see, we are brainwashed and programmed. I don't care what you say. Go to school, go to college, be on top of, get the best job, white collar, blue collar. Y'all know it's the truth. And then, so we focus so much on that. And I'm not saying that God doesn't want you to be successful. But he says, I wish that you prosper even as your soul prosper. People don't understand. That's not just in prosperity. That's why the church is messed up, because of prosperity on the outside and not prosperity on the inside. Come on, somebody. So the transformation started with 2012. And I promise you, I start seeing more. I start hearing more. It started becoming really clear. I said, God, now I can say I really know you. Hallelujah to his name. And that's when, I never forget, he opened my eyes even more so. Spiritual eyesight, insight. And I promise you, I start seeing stuff in church that I never saw before. And it broke my heart, literally. Because I thought, no. I'm saved now and I can see and everything's going to be fine. I saw stuff that I didn't understand, but now I do. I said, God, why in church? He said, because that's the devil's comfort zone. Oh, come on, somebody. Don't forget the message tonight. It's the devil's comfort zone. So wait a minute. How in the heck could he be so comfortable in the church? How can it be comfortable in the church? That's how you know they ain't got no power in the church. There, yes, they're gonna come, but I promise you, I gotta tell you this story. I knew he was gonna, I tell you, I got so much stuff. I am writing a book, by the way. It was already written, my biography. It's thick too. I never forget, it's called Gatekeepers. And I'm gonna tell how some of y'all, especially if you have a position in the church, even if you don't have a position, you want to do your part and bless your pastor, your preacher, your teacher, your prophet, your apostle. I'm about to tell you what God told me to do. So every Wednesday night for Bible study and Sunday, God will make me walk the perimeter. I will walk around the church speaking in tongues or just speaking prayer. Then in the inside, I will go and I'll put some oil on my hand and I'll touch each seat. Now you're going to understand, we had a two-story church. Why I was so tired? I used to have to go an hour and a half before. I was mad at God. I said, why I got to do that? I'm the only one. Because I was the gatekeeper of that house. And I'm going to tell you how I spotted my first warlock. I was sitting down praying just like this. I promise you, because you got to understand, you're coming in agreement that you're the gatekeeper. So every spirit that's in that church, believe it or not, I used to feel when something was not right. I never forget when he came, I did like this bit. And then I just looked at him. And I'm not going to lie to you. I went up to him. I never forget. He was a Caucasian guy. It doesn't matter by color. They're coming in the colors. And you know how I knew he was a warlock? He could not look at me in the eye. He did just like that. I said, oh, we got a real one. And I shook his hand. I'll never forget what I said. I said, you come here and you mess with my pastor, I'll rip you up in the spirit. Yes, I did say it. Yes, I did. And I'm going to tell you right now, and I'm just being honest, they didn't believe me. I told pastor, because God has showed me. I said, pastor, he's going to try to get close to you. He was a millionaire. Money talk, and y'all know what walk. And I'm telling you, I kept telling everybody, because they wouldn't let me to pastor, because at that time, you know, I'm just coming out as a prophet, and they think, woo, everything I say happened. He got close to the pastor. Within 2 months, he was the pastor PA. That warlock turned our church upside down. All I could do is watch, because once I warn and they do what they want to do, all I could do is watch and pray. And he used to laugh. He used to go out the door laughing at me. I really want to fight him physically. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I thought, but you know, you can't do that. I'm just saying, that was the old me. And so I told pastor, I said, don't take no money. Don't do nothing. To this day, you know, that church is in the rave. I'm just being honest with y'all. I'm telling you the truth. And hold on. He turned that church upside down. And there was nothing I could do. There was nothing. Because once, you see, and that's why God is bringing back the prophet office. A lot of people don't believe in prophets no more. And I know a lot of people lie, but not everybody's a liar. But because you don't have the wisdom and the discernment, come on, somebody, hallelujah. That's what we're talking about. That's why you have to ask God for the wisdom and discernment. But just not only that, how about this? You have to understand the anointing. The anointing will spot it. The anointing will see it. The anointing, God will tell you if it's 3 o'clock in the morning. Because if you miss it, the spirit won't miss it. I'm going somewhere with this. How is it that one warlock can mess up a whole church? Now, hold on. By 5-6 months into it, it was too late though. They finally figured it out. People of God, it is time for you to walk around your churches. Walk around your homes. Decree and declare. I did it tonight. People think I'm crazy. I know the next door neighbors be looking at me peeping. I say, you want me to do it to your house too? I walked around here with my oral. I don't care what nobody say. I walk and I decree and declare, because I know where I'm at. I'm in Louisiana. Ain't nothing but witches and warlocks. And they know I know that. They know that I know. And it's on, baby. Let it be on. I don't care, because I ain't scared of none of them. Hallelujah. Because I know what I'm working with and I know who I'm working with. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. That's what this whole life is about. If we don't start getting the power of God for real, it will stop murder. It will stop mayhem. It'll stop diseases. It'll stop killings. It'll stop adultery. It'll stop anything. Hallelujah. Because the power of God will stop it. Hallelujah. God said it should not be what we have going on in these churches. It should not be what we have going on in these streets. It should not be. And that's because the saints are not praying. The saints are not praying. The saints are not praying. And then hold on. The bottom, the foundation of this whole life, y'all got the wrong people praying. Y'all got witches praying. Y'all got warlocks praying. Y'all got them in position, and y'all already know. Let me tell you, I'ma let you identify it. Number one, they're always doing wrong, and yet everybody act like they don't see it. They'll turn their head. I watched that. Number two, they don't live it. And don't act like you don't know it. They don't live it. I'm talking about they preach it, but they don't live it. Number three, lust. I'm going to tell y'all the three things that bring people down to as Christians. And I want you to write it down or just remember it. The lust of the eyes. Don't act like y'all don't know what I'm saying. The lust of the eyes. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. That's why you have to get in that word, because it'll stop you from wanting that you something you shouldn't want or who you shouldn't want. Come on, somebody. Lust of the flesh. That's why some of you go into church, and I know God says come as you are, but he didn't say come and tempt nobody. Come on, somebody. He didn't say come and wear nothing tight. He didn't say come and be lustful. Half of people go to church just to look at brother so-and-so and sister so-and-so. Don't play games. You know it's the truth. And the third one, that's what gets a lot of people, the pride of life. I am a doctor. I have this. I have that. And Satan, that was the same thing that caused the fall and the fight in heaven. Satan had pride. I want to be God. And come on, somebody, don't play with me. You get these degrees, or you get in where you fit in, and y'all start mistreating people that are right in the church. Arrogant. Don't act like y'all don't know what I'm saying. That's why we so say have mega church. What's the difference between a mega church and a local church? Still supposed to serve the same God. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. One body, one Lord, one baptism. Now, hallelujah. Am I tripping? God says the devil is too comfortable in his comfort zone. It's time to make him uncomfortable, people. I'm throwing something out here. Y'all know God have called me to do a 21-day liquid fast. We can do it, because you, for those that think they're going, ooh, you can do smoothies. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. I'm telling you right now what I've learned in my 23 years. If it had not been for me fasting, I promise you I wouldn't be before you. I think they'd have killed me a long time ago, or I'd have killed me. And what I mean by that is making the wrong decisions, making the wrong choices. I hear God and I'm not bragging. I hear God so clear. Sometimes it scares me. I'm not kidding. I was in the store today, and God told me something like a minute before it happened. And I was like, I kind of doubted it, right? I ain't gonna lie. And when it happened, I was like, God, fasting will allow you to hear God like never before. Fasting will allow you to have a relationship like God never before. Fasting will make you see things before it happened and pray about it. Fasting will let you see the spirit of a person, because we got too many. Y'all think I'm lying. My God, I got to say it. Most of the leaders are tainted. And if I call names, y'all get mad at me. Oh, you jealous? Oh, it is. You say what you want to say. I'm gone. I don't care. When the last time you saw him lay hands and heal somebody? When the last time you saw the power of God in that service? Don't play with me. Don't fool me. When the last time? Hallelujah to his name. Well, I'm done right there. Now, if you see money, yeah, I know. If you see cars, I know. If you see all this other stuff in 5, 6, 7, 10, 12 churches, I know. But when the last time have you seen the power of the Holy Ghost? Hallelujah. That's what I'm talking about. Where people get healed. People tired. They sick and tired of just coming to church, living the same way. But yet you want all my money, and I can't barely pay my bills, which I rebuke that name of Jesus. People tithe. Turn around 5 times, you're going to get blessed. Give me $50 and you might get blessed. People tired of that because, to be honest with you, you ain't got to give nothing to God to get blessed but your soul, your heart, your mind, your body. Because you already paid the price on Calvary. So the price was already paid for healing, for deliverance. Hallelujah. Church, I'm telling you what God said. The devil is too comfortable in his comfort zone. It's time to shake him up a little bit. We know you're used to being in the spiritual atmosphere, but you cannot dwell in here. Hallelujah to his name. I pray to God that y'all come on this fast. And if you don't, fine. But just do your part. What is your part? Pray, people. Pray. Pray. But I'm going to be real with you. You won't last if you don't fast. I learned that a long time ago. My God. I didn't want to because I'm from Louisiana. The food good and I like to eat. I bet you that's not my. As a matter of fact, more and more I'm on this fast, I see the transformation. You know, I'm not just trying to look healthy, but I hear God saying this got to be a lifestyle. You're going to the next level, Deanna. You can't go because I'm putting myself on blast. I've been so fickle, up down with my weight, and I know better. This time, I owe God and I owe myself. And I owe everybody that look at me as their mentor, leader, or just a spiritual influence. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. It's time. It's time for us. It's not about us. People need us to be in position so we can fight opposition. Did you hear what I say? People need us to be in position so we can fight opposition. Let me tell you why all these reality shows are up here. Let me tell you why social media, everybody want to be famous now. Everybody want a channel. Everybody want, follow me. Follow me on my Instagram. Follow me on my Snapchat. Follow me on my, man, I don't care if you follow me or not. As a matter of fact, don't follow me. Follow Jesus as I follow Jesus. How about that? We got to do better, church. We got to do better. We got to do better, I'm telling you. Because if you think it's going to get better, you haven't read Revelations. Let me see what else God, I got it written down here. Oh, okay. Thank you, Lord. Then God says this. A lot of you don't have power because even Satan know you. I'm going to end this video with this. You remember the 7 sons of Sceva? And I don't say scripture on purpose because I want you to go in the Bible and find it yourself. I'm not going to give you everything. No, we're supposed to work. That's another thing. Lackadaisy. That's another thing. Y'all always bringing y'all phones. I don't have my tablet right here. Phones, computers, everything. Get your Bible. Hold on. Get your Bible. Let me tell you something. Look at my Bible. Look at my Bible. Falling apart, but that's my Bible. That I'm going to die with this Bible. I'm sorry, baby. Cause hold on. Colorful. I ain't bragging. I'm telling you. I got to eat this. I got to have this. Or I won't survive. Hallelujah. I can't get up on here with power. That's why I'm so powerful. It ain't me. It's what I do. I got to be connected to God. I got to stay connected to God. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Because it ain't me, truth be told. It's the Spirit of God in me. Hallelujah to his name. It's time for us to do our job. The devil too comfortable. It's time to kick him out. He got kicked out of heaven, and it's time for him to get kicked out of your home, out of your marriage, off of your job, out of the church. But you can't do it if you ain't got no power. So I'm going to leave y'all with this, like the demons say. Yes, I'm going to quote them. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you? Now, if they saying that to you, and they are, if you ain't got no power, shame on you. Because I guarantee you they know Deanna Dixon. Think they don't. So I pray that y'all even play this back, because I felt the power of the Holy Ghost. I promise you I did. Ooh, hallelujah. God is so good. Y'all don't see God's trying. God is purifying his church. Every lie is coming down. Everything, every false lie. Y'all don't notice what's happening? God even letting strangers call out people. God tearing down everything that the devil built up. The false church, because that's what it is. God tearing it down piece by piece. He said, because that's my church. That's my people. That's my anointing. That's my Bible. And that was my son that died for you. Hallelujah. God ain't playing. It could be me. Trust me, when we get up on here, we don't understand. That's more judgment, especially if you lying. Hallelujah, I feel the power of the Holy Ghost, y'all. Ooh, so that's all God told me to say. I pray, and oh Lord, I hear you. I keep hearing, stop being so offended. That's how you know you're a babe in Christ. Can I tell y'all something? If y'all would have met my mentors from 1996 to now, y'all think I'm something? Can I tell you, they was 3-4 times. They just made me cry. They used to talk about them. I'd be in the room talking about them. And some of them, when I first started off, I'm gonna be real, I would cuss. And then I have to repent. I'm just being real with you. I was like, God, they're so mean. I said, they can't be a man of God. They can't be a woman of God. But you know what it was? They was calling me on my stuff and I didn't like it. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. People get mad when you call them on their stuff. Don't get mad, baby. Get better. Don't get bitter. Get better. Because truth be told, the Bible says in Corinthians, I chastise the ones that I love. I correct the ones I love. A true leader, a true friend, a true mentor, they're going to tell you the truth. The fake ones, I'll talk about you behind your back and put you on blast on the, over the pulpit. Let's get it together for real. Let's get it together and grow up. Quit getting mad over stuff that don't matter. Because if Jesus come the day of tomorrow, you'll be studying. Let's get this together and kick him out of the church once and for all. Let the church be the church. And by the way, the church is in our spirit. We are the church. We are the church. But I'm going to tell you what God says, and this is the final thing. God said he does not recognize his church. Now that's not pretty. Not holy. Not holy. Talk to each other crazy, cuss at each other, talk about each other. I don't mind being transparent. I used to do it all too. I stopped. The more you get closer to God, you realize you don't have no right to talk about nobody like a dog. Because truth be told, we done did some stuff. Truth be told, we still not perfect. Truth be told, we all didn't hurt somebody. Truth be told, we all didn't make mistakes. Truth be told, God forgave us. Truth be told, he had mercy on us. Where's the same grace and mercy extended to you, to your brother and sister? Now I'm going to leave you on that one. And I just tell you the truth because I love you for real. Because can I tell y'all something? We may not know each other personally, but by my spirit, says the Lord, I know you and you know me. So when I say I love you, I really love you through Christ. Hallelujah. All right, God bless you. I pray that you have learned something because I don't just come on here. I write, I take notes, I fast, I pray. I want to make sure because I won't ever lie. Because what? Remember this, everything you do, everything you don't do, everything you say, everything you don't say, we should surely give account for. So God bless you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Real life soldiers, for that is truly who you are. Let's get it. Kick him out of the church. All right, y'all. I love y'all. God bless you. I bet you said, God got some big eyes, huh? Mm-hmm. All righty.